Good morning all. My name is Vrinda and today I am going to handle database management subject and one topic under database management subject. I am working as an assistant professor under the Department of Information Technology. Okay, so today we will see the topic normalization under database management system. You know very well that normalization is one of the important topic that comes under DBMS. So today let's start the basic concept of normalization. So today I am going to discuss about the basic concepts of normalization like what is actually normalization, what is the definition of normalization, and second we will see what is the need of normalization, why we are normalizing a table or why we are normalizing a relational schema, and third thing we will see how to normalize a table or how to denormalize a table. And finally, we will see the benefits of normalization. Okay, so today we will see all these four topics, and these four topics will come under the basic concept of normalization. And in the future classes, we will see the multiple levels of normalization like 1NF, 2NF, 3NF, like that. So let's start with the basic concept. So first of all, I will just introduce you the introduction, I mean the definition of normalization. So the normalization is nothing but designing a relational schema. Relational schema in the sense a table or a database, or simply we can tell like a schema. So the normalization definition is designing a relational schema to eliminate redundancy. Redundancy means here we are explaining about data redundancy, and along with that we need to eliminate some of the anomalies. Okay, so without explaining what is data redundancy and what are anomalies, we can't able to explain the normalization concept. So before going to explain the definition, I will just explain you the data redundancy part and data anomalies. Okay, so let me just explain you about data redundancy with an example. So for that I am just taking a table. I am just taking a small example with a student table. And student table is having the attributes student ID, student name, department name, department building, and room number. Okay, so this is one small example of a student table. So this student table is having mainly five attributes or five columns we are having. First one is student ID, student name, department name, building number, and room number. Okay, so we can insert some of the values into this table. Like example, student ID is 1 and the name is Rahul, department name is CSE, building number is 1 and room number is 101. Again, I am just adding 2-3 data into this table, like second student ID, again CSE. So the building number will be same and the room number also will be same. So I added 4 data here, and again 5th data I am adding under CSE. So here in this table you can able to see if I am adding any new data, if I am adding any new student detail into this table, we need to repeat some of the data again and again. See, here you can able to see this CSE and this building number and room number. If I need to add any student data under CSE, these 3 details I need to repeatedly adding. See, here also, if I need to add again another student name, for example, XYZ is the student name. Again, if I need to add his name under CSE, again, I need to repeat the same building number one again, and the room number will be also same. So here, what is the main problem we are facing here? Here, data duplication is coming. I mean, the owner needs to add the duplicate data again and again. See, here you can able to easily identify. Here the building number and room number are four times it is repeating. If again some students will come under CSE, means again I need to add. So under a college, you know that more than 1000 students will be come, and more than 1000 or more than 100 students will come under CSE department. So these data, I mean the building number and room number, so this needs to be repeating again and again, 100 times, 200 times, or maybe 500 times. And one more example, if some extra attributes are here, like HOD name and HOD phone number. So if that attributes means one department, obviously it should have only one single HOD. So here again, HOD name needs to be repeating for all the CSE students, and HOD phone number, it is again going to repeat for all the CSE students. This kind of duplicate data, we are naming it as data redundancy. Okay, so hope you understand data redundancy. Data redundancy is nothing but repetition of data under each table. So why we are getting this repetition of data? Because this table is very large. I mean, it contains more than 5 attributes. So every time I need to insert one student data, I need to repeat some of the information again and again. So this repetition, we are naming it like data redundancy. So data redundancy is one of the major trouble under database, because every time storage space will increase, because more than 100 students will come under each department. So each and every student needs to add all these same information again and again. So this data redundancy will comes under a major trouble under database management. So we need to reduce this data redundancy, and through normalization we can able to reduce this data redundancy. And I will tell you how we can able to reduce this data redundancy. Simple way, we need to just decompose our table. So how we can able to decompose our table? We can able to create, or we can able to separate this table into another form. I mean, we can able to create one table with department name and building number with room number. In that you can add CSE under building 1, and room number is 101, and EC is room number 3, and building number 3 and room number is 301, and fashion and technology is under building number 2 and room number is 201. So if we just decompose this table into another form, I mean another department table, we can able to add this department details under this table, and through that we need to avoid this particular attributes from the main table. Okay, so this will come under the student table and this will come under the department table. So each and every time only we need to add what? We need to add only the student ID, student name, and which department that student comes under. Okay, and inside the department name, we don't want to repeat again and again. Only the CSE department comes under building number 1 and the room number is 101. So no need of repetition comes under these two tables. So we can able to avoid this data redundancy. This is the main part comes under data redundancy, I mean the decomposition. So through decomposition of tables, we can able to avoid data redundancy. Okay, so this is one part. As I told you, normalization is nothing but designing a database or designing a relational schema to avoid what? Two points you need to just memorize. You need to avoid data redundancy, and the second thing, you need to avoid some anomalies. So these are the major two points you need to remember under normalization. We are just doing normalization for just avoiding data redundancy and to avoid the anomalies. So I explain you data redundancy and hope you understand how the data redundancy is coming and how we can able to overcome data redundancy by decomposition of tables. Next thing I will explain you about anomalies. So what are anomalies or what is the meaning of anomalies? It is nothing but some of the errors or some of the struggles they are facing to create or to design a database. So this also I will just explain you with one example. So here also I will show you one table for explaining the anomalies. So anomalies are nothing but just errors we are facing to insert, or just the errors we are facing while updating a table or while deleting a table. So anomalies we can able to classify into three types. First one is insertion anomaly. Second one is updation anomaly. And third one is deletion anomaly. Okay, so these are the three major kinds of anomalies, and we need to reduce these three kinds of anomalies through normalization. So normalization we are using to avoid data redundancies, as well as insertion anomaly, updation anomaly and deletion anomaly. So let me explain you what are these three kinds of anomalies with one table. Again, I am taking the same table, student. Student ID is one attribute, student name, department, building number and room number. So the same table I am taking again for explaining the anomalies, and some 3-4 students are there. Just I am inserting some 3-4 student names. Under each department, okay, so finally so let's see, 5 data are available, 5 student data are available under the student database. So first I am just explaining you the anomalies. Anomalies means the first anomaly, insertion anomaly. So hope you remember about primary key under each table. So primary key is nothing but a unique key which needs to identify a data under a table. So under this table, this is a student table, and here we can just keep student ID as a primary key. So student ID means with the help of student ID we can able to get all the data of each student. With student ID 1 I can get all the data of student ID 1. I mean I can get student name, department name, building number and room number. So I am just keeping student ID as here primary key. Okay. So insertion anomaly means we are facing troubles to insert some data into a table. So here let me just explain you, if I need to add one new department detail. New department detail means in my college one new department newly added. New department, electrical and electronics engineering, triple E department, one new department came to our college and it added to our college. So till now no students was enrolled under this department. Nobody is available under triple E department. How we can able to add this department detail? This department comes under the 4th building and room number is 401. We will face trouble to insert this department detail under this table because we require primary key, and none of the students are till now nobody joined under triple E department. So we couldn't able to add this triple E department under this student table because we don't have any primary key and we don't have any students joined under triple E department. But still our college is having triple E department, but still we can't able to add this triple E department under our database. This kind of errors we are telling like insertion anomalies. We couldn't able to add some data under a table because we don't have any primary key, we don't have any student ID under AAA department. So we couldn't able to add this AAA department under our student database. So this we are referring under insertion anomalies. Okay, thank you all. We will see you in next class.